What's up, guys? Charles Blaze here, and today we're going to be starting off with a new series, Titanfall 2. I know a lot of people have heard about it. It's made by Respawn, the team that made Apex Legends, and I think they made Jedi Fallen Order. So this was one of their most underrated games, and a lot of people still enjoy it. So we're going to be starting off with the campaign, and let's get into it.
Of all the things I've seen on the battlefields of the frontier, the pilot is the true dominant force. Fast and agile. Graceful, yet devastating. Perceptive, resourceful, and relentless. A pilot sees the world differently. Sheer walls become flanking routes. Pilots fight differently. Experienced in deception and maneuver, even overwhelming odds shift in their favor. But what truly separates the pilot from all the grunts and machines of the battlefield is the bond between a pilot and a Titan. To a Titan, a pilot can only be stopped by overwhelming force or an equal. The frontier has been the only home I've ever known. For years, our lands have been destroyed by the IMC, forcefully taking our resources, polluting and destroying our planets, and killing us off if we try to resist. Despite recent victories at Demeter and beyond, we have a long way to go before the IMC is defeated. Now, I serve as a rifleman in the militia, fighting to free the frontier. I'm a long way from becoming a pilot. But when that day comes, I hope I can live up to the honor.
So yeah, that was basically, I think, exposition about how the story goes. You're working for another government, going against another government, and trying to defend yourself. It's basically America, in a nutshell.
Here we go, Rifleman Cooper. Oh, hell. Ship must have power cycled the Simpod since last time. We'll have to recalibrate it.
Hold on, guys, let me just yeah, this is better.
Does that feel right to you, Cooper? Alright, we're good to go. Let's see how much you remember from last time. Setting the neural link. Not quite the same as a Titan link, but it's similar. To learn new skills, we need to be in the right state of mind. Ah, much better.
It's still a little
technically,
little
I'm not
laggy.
Supposed to be training you. I think you want to see potential. Besides, we're at war. Who's got time for class training? Let's pick up the pace, enabling jump kids. Jump kits operate on the principle of relaxed ability. Once your jump kit calibrates to your movement style, enhanced mobility becomes second nature. Isn't it?
Yeah, this is better now.
Good. Now you're moving. Under here, stay low.
yeah, just giving off the introduction to the game.
We've retaken over a quarter of frontier space in the Battle of Demeter. The militia is better organized now. More people join every day in frontier. People like you. In combat, things never go as you expect. You must be ready to use any weapon you can find on the field. These are just a few of the weapons I've come across out there. Time to hit the range. Load your weapon.
Wait, that's a little loud.
Take them all out before we can move on.
I'm just gonna put that. I forgot that was there. Alright. That's still loud.
Good. Practice more if you want, then head to the gauntlet.
Yeah, that's still loud. I'm just gonna keep it there. So basically this game, what made this game different from other games was the whole movement system.
So a new gauntlet for you to run today.
Like so, what made this game different from other games was the fact that the whole movement system, it wasn't new, but it was the first game that allowed you to use it freely as you want. Like, the game didn't force you to wall jump across that space, wall run this part, you can do it however you want. Because the faster you walk in the game, the more better you would fight. That was my fastest run.
Nice run. See the results board on the wall? You set a new base time. Everyone has different strengths and weaknesses, so be sure to run this a few times with different weapons. Look at the results board for more tips on how to improve. Now that you're warmed up, you want a real challenge. You can race against other pilot ghosts. Word of warning though, pilots who recorded these ghosts are the best in the SRS. If you can beat them, be on your way to being a real pilot. Go ahead and run the gauntlet as much as you want. When you're done,
yeah, I did my best, so that was my fastest run. Normally I get like 50 seconds in. 45 seconds is my fastest. I get like 56 to 6 minutes.
The only ones allowed to do that?
Only a simulation rifle. It's not but first, you need a little more space. That's my partner, BT. He's a Vanguard class. Homegrown militia technology. The first Titan chassis we designed ourselves. One we didn't have to steal from the IMC. Go ahead, rifleman. On your first Titan. Look up, Scott. There he is. All right, rifleman. Sounds like it's about to hit the fan. I'm pulling you out.
Powering down all non-essential systems.
Cooper, ready up.
Easy, Cole. You just left VR. He needs a minute to decompress. He'll be ready to go. Trust me.
Yes, sir.
Heads up. They're killing us. Right. Good session in there. You'll get the hang of it someday. We'll make a pilot out of you yet, rifleman. But not today. No time.
Lastimosa.
Anderson.
You son of a bitch. See you down there.
Okay,
you're ready to see a new planet today. die on it. See you down there, Rifleman. Good luck.
Get your ass out of the Simpod, Cooper. Meet at the dropship.
Ah, yes. A space AK-47. We are the good guys. We use space AK-47s in this game. Okay, don't even ask me. Just give me my difficulty. I was gonna go on hard, like, that's something. And before anyone asks why I'm not going for Master, I did try to make another video, but a lot of it got corrupted because of a power outage, so I couldn't make that, and I was playing Master on that. And let's just say that this game punishes you for even the slightest mistake, and even though I'm good at it, I'm not that good to beat it on Master and record it. Like, sure, I could beat it if I wanted to, but it wouldn't be that fun. That's a nice way to show your game title. It would be really funny if they just like killed Cooper off in the beginning and then you just run a militia grunt number 2. I mean, it would be funny, not fun, but it would be funny. They're giving me drugs. We're definitely the good guy now. Space AK-47 and drugs. Yep, we're good guys. So even on hard, this game isn't easy. And there goes half the team. The game doesn't let us play for a rifleman a long time. Like, they just barely go in 5 minutes into it and you're back and you're a pilot.
Cooper, you're in bad shape. Hold on. That's why I knocked you out. You should be okay when you wake up. That's the most
hostile Titan. More drugs. Why don't I OD already?
Copy that, BT. Mercenaries. Stay down, Cooper.
I love how they emote the sword guy emotes on VT. Like, you two. Like, you two just had to join together to beat him. One on one, they both would have lost. What is that? Is here?
Alone, you
I love how they're like every villain they have in the Apex Predators are just generic villain guy. There's Richter, the sixth guy, Ash, the guy who's Ash, the person who's like the cold, calculated genius. You've got Kane's teammate, I don't know her name. She's basically the boss's right hand man. I'm surprised you didn't shoot me. I'm surprised I didn't shoot Cooper at this moment. Like, the weapon BT is using isn't an assault rifle. You can't aim down with that thing, so you're inaccurate as hell. The fact that he didn't shoot me was purely luck. Another thing is the Viper. The Viper's the only cool boss among the Apex Predators. The rest of them are just cannon fodder or generic bad guy number 5. That's what they are. They're just generic.
BT, transfer authorization to pilot. Link. Bravo Tango 727. Trooper, take my Titan. Use my helmet in my jump kit. This is the real thing. Take care of him.
For those who want to read, you can just read this. Just pause and read if you want to. It's basically what it's. If you play Dead Space, you can Dead Space 1 actually. You can see Isaac's logbook, like what he thinks personally is happening, or what his reaction is to all of this. That's what the logbook is for Cooper as well. Also. I think a lot of people just think Titanfall 2 has a generic campaign, and I agree. Like, the campaign's good, it's not bad, it's not that special, it's got a good factor into it. The characters are somewhat memorable, only two of them. That's the Mosa, because he's the only one who gives you your Titan and BT, that's it. Other characters like the leader of the Resistance, I forgot her name already, and I've played this game twice. And others like the villain, I think his name is Blitz. You barely remember them because they're not that special. Like, Blitz is generic guy bad guy who lets live. Kane is just the sick guy who's like the psychopath of the team. Ash is, like I said, the genius. And then there's that person who's Blitz's right hand person, whose name I forgot. Like I said, they're not special, they're just generic bad guys. I'll just keep my current weapons. That health bar, like I shot that thing more times. They died quickly before, I don't know why they're not dying right now. The game already tells you that you get faster with every time you slide or wall run, but in order to go faster, you need to go like wall run, slide, and then not sprint. If you sprint, you lose your speed. That's a you don't get your double jump alert until you get the first battery. I was like, why isn't my double jump working? Which is annoying because the double jump is like. This game, like I said, this game actually makes you use your parkour stuff, like, to make the gameplay more enjoyable. It isn't just, oh hey, We're not gonna make you use that move you use unless we want to. And there's the execution. I did not know you could jump that distance. That was pure accident. Okay, now I got my double jump. Oh, you can hack the robot from this thing, by the way. Alright. I keep forgetting that I keep forgetting that you don't need to sprint after ball running, because if you cancel your slide and sprint, you lose all the speed. There's an enemy behind me. It's also disappointing that they only use only these creatures in this mission. Like after this mission, you barely see these creatures.
Okay.
don't get why the frames are lowered in this one.
Power at 2/3. Data core reinitialized. Ocular system online. Adjusting focus. Are you all right, pilot? My systems are rebooting, but a third battery will accelerate the process. I will remain here.
Sorry about missing that dialogue, guys. I was just looking at any settings that would make the game look better.
To all militia personnel, the IMC will grant safe passage back to the Angel City Penitentiary. To all who surrender, be wise to turn yourself in to any IMC search team.
Pilot, I advise against turning yourself over to the IMC. Voice pattern analysis indicates they are lying.
Don't worry, BT. I'm not going anywhere.
Understood, but I do recommend you move. IMC salvage teams are not far away. Pilot, my mapping systems have been restored. The ambush of the 9th Militia Fleet has landed us far off course from our original destination. We are located in a hostile territory. Careful, we cannot stay here long.
How long did you serve with Lastimosa?
Captain Lastimosa linked with me 973 days ago.
Sorry. I jumped off early. I'm sorry about the whole clutter, camera movement, guys. I love how Cooper's working in the same military and he doesn't know the name of the commanding officers. Like, isn't that just telling you how bad, how much of a, like, terror bad guy group is? You don't even know the leader of your own team.
Yeah,
think we go down here.
Yep.
Let me just hit that. I love you can do that. Like, I never knew that you could do that from the beginning.
Enemy reinforcements will be on their way. We must complete the Neuralink immediately. Please install the final battery.
I love how in this moment where we could possibly die, he's still trying to be kind.
We're at full capacity.
Like, please, we're gonna die. I know you're new to this, but please, hurry up. Now this is one of the fun parts of the game. I also love how different embarks are given in this game. Like, you could, in the multiplayer especially, if you play multiplayer, you're gonna enjoy it. How your Titan grabs you and just puts you inside. Like, it's really fun. And we're getting short sets. Can we move on, please?
Reinitializing critical systems. Vortex shield online. The vortex
shield. I love how they're take your time. Can we move now, please? Thank God.
Pilot, enemy Titanfall detected. We will have to find our way.
Wait, what? Oh yeah, they're friendly. I forgot I had that. That was easy.
Our combat effectiveness rating has increased. Pilot, I detect more IMC salvage teams on the way. Our only chance of survival is to uphold our mission of rendezvousing with Major Anderson. Until then, you and I are on our own. Marking your HUD.
Alright guys, I think this is our mission end. So, if you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. And I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.